I go in with my buddy, crazy friend from Holland, not a house. And sure enough, they started, they suddenly asked me, because I'm jumping around and having fun, you know, hey, what's up, everybody, you know what I mean? And I tried to make friends with everybody, tried to speak Swedish, you know, and they say, can you come with us? So we go to these two doors, through these two doors, and there's a big fire stairs, like a marble stairs, giant. And he says, well, we want you to leave. I said, why? I said, well, you're too much energy, you're flopping around, it's not good, you're bothering the customers. I said, sure, okay, but can you tell my friend, my buddy's over here, he's also from Holland, can you tell him that I'm gone, because otherwise, you know, he can't find me. So they didn't expect that. They thought I was going to do something, of course, so he pushes me. And I said, now why would you push me? I said, I want to go, it's okay, you know, I don't want any trouble. And he started putting his finger on my chest, which is something I really can't stand, right? So I said, okay, don't touch me, because if you do that again, it's going to go wrong. And sure enough, they were looking for a fight, of course. He did it again, so I pushed him, and another guy behind him jumped over him, and he stabbed the finger in my eye. I said, guys, come on, let's stop this right now. I don't want to boop my other eye. And there I went, boom, and that guy went down. He went down like one punch. I've never seen anything. I heard him over the music. I heard that. Yeah, that was the wildest thing ever. And then they had these little microphones, right? So with, yeah, I don't know, but fast. It was four or five guys. And they start fighting. And the guy that I knocked out constantly, because he would wake up, right? And everything went good and went good. But then I start realizing, wait a minute. These guys are going to come back up all the time, you know. This is going to come to an end. I got to get the hell out of here.
So you're knocking them down. So you're hitting them. They're falling down. Everyone that's coming at you, you're knocking down. But you're realizing you got
to
get out of here.
I had to get out of there. And there's one part, until this day, I have no clue what this was. I'm falling against a wall. And there's a hole in the wall, you know, with a little bar in front of it. And there's broomsticks. Broomsticks. But no brooms on broomsticks. Just... So I'm grabbing one, but right away when I grab one, I think to myself, I say, if I grab one, they're going to grab one. So I leave it, and I go, but they passed it, and they all took a freaking broomstick.
Oh, no.
And I go, oh, you know. So man,
it now was you're fighting five so guys wild. With broomsticks.
It was wild. And then I had to get the hell out of there. So I went all the way down. And I remember till this day, it was a door that, you know, one of these copper things that you have to push in and then you open up. So I click and it's closed. And I'm going, okay, yeah, now what? You know, so I turn around and I thought, okay, now I'm going to go only for the eyes. I'm going to hit him in the throat. I'm going to kick him in the balls. That's the only thing I'm going to go for now. And they looked at me and they all stepped back. So I go, whoa, they can see I mean business, right? But behind me is the whole police force outside because there were windows. So they throw me in jail. And because apparently one of those bouncers was a cop. And yeah, and I knocked him out, of course, also. But he never told me that he was a cop. Otherwise, I wouldn't have done that. Anyway, we're there. And this is actually a funny story. Because before this all happened, I'm talking to my wife. And I'm already tanked, right? And she says, why are you laughing? Why are you having so much fun? I said, honey, I'm drunk. I'm having a lot of fun. She says, no, you're there with two Swedish blonde girls, huh? I said, honey, don't worry about it. You know me. If I'm drunk, you know, I don't care about anything. Especially not that. I just want to have fun. So after 2 days, they allowed me to give my first phone call. And I'm calling my wife. And she's freaking out. I said, honey, you got to be, okay, relax, relax. I say, I got some good and some bad news. What do you want to hear first? She says, the good news. I say, I didn't fuck two Swedish girls. She says, the bad news is I'm in jail. You think this is fun? She's going to hate me for this story because every time she says, you should tell us. You know, it's not funny. I think that's a hell of a story. I love that. Right?